Welcome to my YouTube channel where I teach women how to build a great relationship with their man. How many times have you tried to talk to your boyfriend or husband, but he couldn't focus or listen to what you're saying? In my relationship, it actually happens very few times as I have learned when to talk and when not to talk to my boyfriend so I can get his full attention to what I have to say. It isn't nice, is it, when you want to open up and share your feelings or something exciting in your life with him, yet he seems not interested or distracted by many things going on in his life or problems in his business. It hurts our feelings as we tend to link their lack of attention as they care about us less or we aren't important to them. The truth is, ladies, he cares for you a lot. It's just how he cares for you might be different from how you care for him or how you think he would act if he cares for you. Regardless, I agree that we all want to have our man's undivided attention when we talk. It is any woman's need in a relationship, really. And I will help you achieve it if you actually apply all the tips and the teaching that I will share with you in this video. Before you want to have a conversation with him about something, it is important to know when is the time to talk to him and when is the time to not talk to him. It doesn't matter how exciting the news is. If you talk to your man when he's stressed or tired, he won't be able to keep the conversation long with you. However, if you approach him when he's in a great state, he then can listen and keep his attention and the conversation with you. He will actually want to listen to you and engage with you. Next, there are a few things about men that women we need to know about. The first is, men like to solve problems. And the second one is, men are wired to detect any potential threat in the environment. This is not what men decide to be or to do, but instead, throughout the history of evolution, men have built themselves in having these characteristics, rooted as survival purpose. When you know these distinctive characteristics that make men who they are, you will understand why your man behaves or reacts in certain ways when you talk to him. For example, you want to talk about how long your day at work is or how something has bothered you this week with him. Instead of just listening to you and validate your feelings by nodding his head or tell you how hard this week was or how amazing you were able to handle what happened, he finds ways to solve your problems when you don't ask him to. I mean, you appreciate he tries to help, but many times, we as women, when we talk to our men, is to express our frustrations about what happened, not because we want to ask them for the solutions for our problems. When he tries to find ways to solve whatever you bring up to him, you feel disconnected from him, you don't feel hurt, and you feel like he doesn't listen to what you're saying. Though the truth is, he loves you so much that he hates to see you frustrated or upset about work, money, or whatever going on in your life. So he tries to find a solution to help you feel better. It just happens that it is not what you're asking for or what you need from him at that particular time. Another scenario is when you go out with your boyfriend or husband at a restaurant. When you're talking, he starts to look around the restaurant. He doesn't seem like he has his full attention on you and the conversation. Ladies, what I want to emphasize here is that men are wired to detect any potential threats. Their eyes will look around, especially when you're in public, because there's too much noise, sound, people talking and walking. This is not what he decides to do, but it's completely based on the biology through the history of evolution. He unconsciously gets distracted easily from you as his instinct. He absolutely doesn't choose to get distracted when you're talking, as you might think. Knowing about this trait can help you in your relationship. If he starts to seem distracted, don't be upset or angry at him, but let him know that you would want him to focus on you again so you can finish what you are talking about. He then will be more conscious and will work on his focus on you and the conversation. You can also save important topics that you want to talk about with him at home so there will be no distraction. This is you helping yourself, your man, and your relationship. Last but not least, let him know what you want and what you need from him before you start the conversation. Let him know that you just want him to listen and validate your feelings so he can just sit back, relax, and listen to you. Without you letting him know, he will listen to you with the assumptions that he needs to solve your problems because men are wired to solve problems. When they see any problems, especially if their girlfriend or their wife has a problem, they will want to solve it right away as an act of love. Your man will just listen enough to know what's going on, what's the problem, and what's the solution, instead of actually listen to you, validate your feelings, and understand you the way you want him to. This is exactly what I use and apply to my relationship with my boyfriend. And it works. That's why I share this with you in this video. Remember that he may forget and jump into the solving problem mode. When this happens, all you need to do is to remind him that you only need him to listen to you and validate your feelings, not to solve your problems. He will be happy to just sit back, relax, and listen to you again. I have so many relationship tips and advice that I'm sure will help you, your man, and your relationship. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel and turn the bell notification on so you will be notified when my next video is out. Leave the like on this video if you enjoy it so far. Thank you for your attention. I hope you have a great day. Take care, and I will see you in my next video. Bye bye.